I'm Tanaz and I am a secondary teacher, so I teach primarily maths and science, and I also teach some cooking and some health subjects as well. The Science Inquiry Project is run from 7 to 12 at the college, and it's basically an investigation process to introduce the students and to expand their skills in science inquiry. So they're given a booklet at the beginning that takes them through the basic structure of what they need to do, but the topic is completely up to them, and they're basically working one-on-one with their teacher to guide them through the whole process of science inquiry, from coming up with the question to how do I test that question, the theory behind it, and then doing their experiment and producing a report at the end of it. I generally start the conversation, so I sometimes talk about things that I'm really interested in. I tend to find if you're enthusiastic, other people tend to be. So I talk to them sometimes about the research I've done or topics that I'm really interested in, and we just brainstorm as a class. Or have you ever thought of why does that happen, or how does this happen, or if they're really stuck, I can say, okay, so what's your hobby? What do you enjoy? Ignore science. What do you enjoy? Okay, where's the science in that?
So basically I was looking at the amounts of bacteria and what types of bacteria you'd find on school objects that we'd find and commonly touch. So basically what I had to do is I went around certain places of the school and I swabbed them with a cotton swab, and then I put them in a snap-lock bag and then took them back to the labs so I could swab them on the agar plate. Put the agar plate lid back on and put it in the incubator for about a week, and then also over that time I observed the changes and the growth of the bacteria.
Before we get to the inquiry, we will do some practical experiments. So they will have been taken through the concept of writing a report, the sections of a report, how we use the language in science, what a method is, fair testing, all those sorts of concepts are introduced before we get to the science inquiry in grade 7.
I didn't know basically till I did this project of what I really wanted to do career-wise. And I really think that I realise I want to get into medical research or do something with chemistry or something to do with the human body. And I really think that that's given me that push, and if I hadn't participated or got onto that topic, I never would have found out how much or deeply I care about it.
It really gives the class a sense of purpose. Everybody's very busy off working on their own task and then helping each other. And it's a really lovely dynamic in the classroom when we're doing these projects, especially when they're getting their boards ready. So part of it is the excitement of science. Science isn't always, you know, textbooks and that sort of thing. It's very dynamic. There's lots of different areas. They often help each other with their experiments. So if they need a few extra hands, someone will go over and help. So part of it is that excitement and inspiration about science to get them really engaged in what they're doing.
I think it's a really good tool to learn, because usually at school you get given a set thing you need to learn, so like genetics or whatever, but with the science inquiry you get to look into the science that you're interested in.
I knew what type of topic I wanted to get into because I'd recently done biology, so I knew I wanted to do something medicine or to do with the body. So my teacher really helped me be able to find a question that would be achievable that I would be able to look at myself.
So the science fair at the end of their project, depending on how many girls we have, we try to take as many as we can, and we go down to the university and are involved in the fair there. So there's students from schools all around, and they bring the boards, as you can see here, and they put together their display, and they're judged by scientists generally from the university. They really enjoy being able to present their work and be proud of their work and talk to real scientists about the real research they've been doing. So I think it's a real highlight for the girls to have that sense of purpose and meaning to what they're doing. And it's always a fun day out. Because every student's doing their own thing, practicality is a big one. Particularly, as I said earlier, you've got multiple classes doing it at once. So both learning and practicality, because you've got to differentiate for each student their type of topic and their level of understanding of scientific process, you really have to help guide the student to just be on their comfort level, and that will range. So there's a lot of, in terms of learning, there's a lot of differentiation. There are obviously some safety ground rules of what they can and can't use, and beyond that it's an individual negotiation with their teacher about what is and isn't appropriate to be doing in the lab here, or what we can or can't. We try as hard as we can to get our hands on whatever the students need. Obviously some are a little bit challenging.
I tested microwaving, steaming and boiling broccoli to test the vitamin C content,
And I've actually found out a lot both in the experimentation and theory. So I found out in the theory, you know, microwaving can fragment the DNA. And so then I would like to research into that further, and that was my original experiment, but I had problems with measuring the radiation and stuff. But that really had an effect on my life, because now I will only use the method that I found to be most effective, because I, you know, I want it to be healthy, what I'm eating. And I think definitely in all of science, I relate everything to it, and it's so cross-disciplinary with physics and chemistry and biology, and I use it in pretty much every subject as like a backup for what I'm saying.
They all approach it really maturely. They're being young scientists and they're going about doing their scientific work, and they're very happy about that. And so the engagement comes from that. They get to pick their topic, and we encourage them to choose an interest or a hobby or an area they're keen on. And I think once they're doing that, they're finding out the answer to a question they want to know about. It's relevant to their lives. It's meaningful. They have responsibility of it. It becomes this thing that they're doing that's really important. And I think that engagement, that's where the engagement comes from.